Just I'll not take much time actually, since you know already. Before that, actually, I want to, because some people might have some you know, like a gift. I want to make them what is the how the sugar distillery or integrated sugar works actually. This presentation is made for liquid discharge in a sugar distillery based upon molasses juice, cane juice, and grain actually. I'll go to the process flow sheet actually. My process flow sheet is visible.
Sir, it is visible.
Okay. See, this is the sugar factory and distillery process flow sheet actually. This sugar is weighed actually, and then it go to the cane milling or I think you can mute others, Chetan. Cane milling and crushing. And then after the juice, it goes to clarification. From the milling, there's a bagasse which comes out, that is 30%, which goes to boiler. Okay, from that boiler, the steam, it goes to turbine, and then power which is generated, that is there's a cogeneration power, either it goes to grid or factory. Okay, so there's a boiler ash. This can go to brick or cement industry, or it can go mix with compost in a press mud. Okay, so and then clarified juice, it goes to this juice go to clarification, and from the clarification there's a press mud which is generated, as you know, morning professor told 4%, which can go as a manure for a decomposition. This manure I'm going to use, and then this ash I'm going to use in the next my presentation. Apart from that, there is a spent wash. Okay, so there is a spent wash that is coming. Okay, I'll come to here. There's a after that juice sulfitation, there's a syrup boiling, and then centrifugation, and then sugar 10-12%, again molasses which comes 4%. This fermentation will happen. After the fermentation, there's a distillation. Okay, from the distillation, there's a spent wash. Okay, this spent wash is taken generally to MEE, multi effect operator, to reduce the water content, okay, or to increase from 10% to 40% or 50% spent wash concentration. This spent wash is generally nowadays are doing incineration by using coal or whatever other methods, okay, and then or this also is used in as a boiler fuel, okay, or co-incineration. The ash will come, maybe it will go, but however, this condensate or concentrate will be taken for composting also. Okay, either it can go to MEE or it can go to biomethanation followed by composting. Okay, so the problem is because of the used land area required, they are reducing the volume. Okay, that is from 10% concentration to 60%, 70% concentration, as morning professor told. So this is what I am going to use this compost after biomethanation or concentration, and I am going to use this press mud, and then I am going to use this ash from the various, and then there is a one more waste which is coming from the fermentation yeast actually. This yeast also goes to the composting. Okay, so this is what I think another one. This is the material balance has been done. I'll not go to detail about the material balance of that. Okay, I hope what is that required I have shown, and where is the input are coming for my composting actually. So the composting of distillery spent wash using the sugar factory press mud. So there's a distillery spent wash is amongst the most recalcitrant industrial effluent, okay, which is a very high organic and odor generating and high color. Okay, and this is the recalcitrant, they call it as. Okay, it has got a BOD of around in case if it is a spent wash, which has got a BOD of 40,000 to 50,000 milligram per liter, COD of 1 lakh to 1 lakh 20,000 milligram per liter. Okay, if it is concentrated, it can go even up to maybe a double or so. Okay, so for distillery attached to sugar factory composting system is a novel approach to spent wash management actually. Okay, so it also maybe assures zero pollution, because all the liquid or semi liquid which is generated, which is consumed by the dry solid that is in press mud and other ash actually, this can be converted as a valuable organic component. So solid state fermentation, this also it is called, there are, you know, liquid state fermentation, solid state fermentation, or maybe continuous fermentation, okay, batch fermentation. So in that it falls under solid state fermentation, because we are going to use some slurry as well as press mud which is in the solid, okay. So this makes it makes use of another organic waste, actually, that is sugar factory press mud which is generated, or maybe fermentation yeast which is generated, or maybe the boiler ash which is generated from the in case if it is a agro based boiler fuel, okay. It cycles back to the soil organic matter and part of the nutrient removed from the soil by crop, actually, in a form that restores the delicate ecological balance of the soil. Soil is required a rich nutrient, that is the NPK value. Okay, sugar factory and distillery a symbiosis, actually. So that means it should go hand in hand. It cannot be separate, or if it is a separate, then there is a possibility of a large environmental impact on the society, actually. So that is the reason both should be there together, and then can be managed and can be achieved, that whatever possible, and this organic matter can be improve this soil chemical, physical, biological properties which require to be done, actually. Okay, so anyhow, I'm not going to discuss. I think morning the same thing shown by explained by Manja Prasad also. So this is a press mud, a source of organic matter, and act as a absorbent for the spent wash, actually. This is a press mud, they have made windrows, actually. This is the windrows they call it as. So on the windrows, there is there will be a sprinkle. The spent wash is going to be sprinkled, okay. And then once it is sprinkled, then there's a aero tiller is there. In the aero tiller, they will mix this thing, and then it will be applied regularly, and then mixed and then left for decomposition, or maybe conversion, actually. Okay, composition of the press mud. So I'll not go to detail about the composition of the press mud. Anyhow, I'm going to share this PPT. You can just go through it, what all it containing compositions. Okay, you can see this, maybe some parameter around 70,000 to 80,000 COD, and 24,000 to 30,000 BOD, and then solids will be 125,000 solids. Okay, so like the dissolved solids. And even press mud will have some more inorganic component also. That is the reason it takes longer time to decomposition, because of this other inorganic component. It takes time. You can see the spraying of biomethanated spent wash over a composting windrows, actually. So this is how there is like a trickling bed filter. You might have seen like that. There's a distributor, actually. So this will be distributed regularly, and then aerotilled this, okay. So the composting process, actually, so the cycle it is called. So in 1 week what will happen, in 2 to 7 week what will happen, and in 8 week what will happen, okay. So here it takes about 8 weeks, 60 days to complete one cycle, and involves the following activities, okay. So in 1 week, actually, this windrows will be done, like this windrows will be done, okay. That is maybe 2 or 3 meter height, maybe 1.5 meter, or maybe depending upon the length is available, 100 meter, 200 meter, or whatever it is, okay. First pass of aero tiller to reduce the moisture content in windrows, okay, from 70% to 50%, okay. Inoculation with microbial culture, that is 30% suspension in water. They use liquid live microorganism in some cases, okay. And aero drilling for a proper mixing of inoculation. Okay, first they will do the seeding, and then mix it, and then remove the moisture. And from the second week, okay, they don't apply your spent wash. Only from the second week they are going to apply spent wash. The effluent, the spent wash spraying, aero drilling maintenance of moisture between 50% to 60%. Effluent spraying is done thrice a week, actually. Okay, so alternative days it will be sprayed, actually. Aero tiller passes after every effluent spray. Trimming of windrows after every aero drilling to reshape with the windrow of triangular position. Okay, like this, they have to make it. That's why they do the trimming also. Okay, or tilling. So after 8 weeks, actually, then at the 8 week curing and aging drying happen in at 8 weeks actually. At the time, maybe after 7 week, optimum moisture content is maintained. Actually, in the temperature in the initially maybe here maybe a 25-30 or maximum 40 might be there. Once you inoculate it, allow it, it may rise to some 35-40, and then during this process it may rise to 45 or 40, and at the time of complete decomposition it may even up to go up to 60-65 degree and 75 degree. Once the temperature drops, and then it shows that decomposition is completed, and then you can ready for screening or whatever disposal dispatch purpose actually. Okay, this is what is the composition in the process actually. So factor influencing the composting, okay, as you know, the particle size should be less, and the if it is a less particle size and you will have more surface area, it is a faster composting decomposition. And this is a very critical parameter has to be maintained actually, 25:1 carbon nitrogen ratio, and pH also should be slightly acidic, and then it can go or rise to alkaline. Okay, the windrows the dimension has to be maintained, and the temperature also has to be maintained to 50-65 degree temperature. That is the most important. Moisture also should be maintained, that is also 50-60, otherwise this this mesophilic or thermophilic bacteria available might get killed in case if you don't maintain the temperature, moisture. So aeration has to be done to flush out our gases or other trapped gases in the compost actually, either hydrogen or CO2, which has to be flushed out. That is the reason the aeration or aerotilling is done regularly or alternatively. Okay, so this optimum requirement of compost, this is the other parameter what is given, it is mentioned here. Okay, so you can see the aerotilling operation actually. This will mix this like this from the bottom, and then you can see the temperature because of the this moisture water vapor which is generated from the compost actually. Okay, so this is the batch culture. You might have seen in a microbiology, there is a batch, it is like a batch culture only. Okay, there is a lag phase, logarithmic phase, and then acceleration phase, and then stationary phase, deceleration phase, and death phase or decay phase. You might have come across in your batch culture cultivation. Okay, similarly it is also like a fermentation and batch culture. It works solid state fermentation. This is how the microbial population increase and then maintain, and as the substrate lack of substrate, it gets died or maybe vanished or maybe nil maybe the microbial population. This is what is called as a microbial batch culture, time versus temperature, or maybe a number of it is given in temperature here, and whereas in a cell mass so they will give a log number. Okay, this number increases, then accelerate, decelerate, and then like that it will be shown in the other system. Okay, as I told you, there are two types of air. Cyclophilic bacteria may not be used because of the temperature. Okay, even if it is whatever is available also might get killed. Okay, and only the mesophilic and thermophilic bacteria stage only which works actually. Okay, so here this generally containing bacteria, fungi, or actinomycetes, or some of them are available microorganism. In the case of bacteria, Bacillus subtilis, or maybe, sorry, I have not done italic actually here. Fungi is Aspergillus fumigatus, and actinomycetes is a Streptomyces. That is what is available. And even this is a thermophilic, or maybe depending upon the temperature conditions, which works, as you know. So this is the composting bacteria, composting bacteria. Okay, so and then this is the fungi bacteria which is taken in a microscope. Okay, and this is the actinomycin bacteria which is taken because it is covering me, that is the reason I am closing. Okay, so this is shown actually. So compost windrows ready for dispatch actually. So this is the ready compost for dispatch to end user. Okay. So this goes to maybe Trommel mill or maybe some screen mechanical screening, and then they will reduce the required size of 4 mm. Generally, the 4 mm is used packed in for the sending for compost. And in case if required, they go for pelletization also in some of the cases, so that they can dissolve slowly in when they are applying in the agriculture land. When is the compost is ready? As already told you, around 8 to 10 weeks this compost is going to be ready, and it's reduce all the bad odor, and sometime they may add, in case if there is any macro micronutrients scarcity is there, they will test that, and then they will add some bauxite or maybe a rock phosphate or maybe a some other material, other natural nutrients can be added and can be sent for dispatch. So this is the compost quality is required actually. So I'm going to share this. You can check this moisture, pH, all other parameters are available. This is the monitoring is required. So future of the compost process. So that is what are the advantages, what it is told actually. This is zero pollution process. BOD of effluent is destroyed in this decomposition. That is natural decomposition. All the degradable organic material is oxidized to humus, that is a fertilizer, okay, manure. Odor, no odor nuisance. Of course, there is a odor nuisance, but can be minimized by applying some odor inhibiting components, okay. So fly nuisance also to some extent is available, but we have to optimally maintain the moisture and then can reduce the fly nuisance, okay. So the product is dry, baggageable, and has a high nutritional value for all type of crops and soils actually. Okay, compost is free from weed, seed and pathogens. Okay, obviously because this pathogen will not survive, or weed seeds will not survive in a higher temperature of 50 to 60 degree temperature. So that is the reason it's free from. And even pathogen comes from excreta and other sources, that is avoided here. So may not be available in most of the cases. So maybe it is a very interesting material balance have been given actually. See, crushing capacity, if you take a 500, so he has given the calculation actually, how to calculate and what is the requirement. Okay, the crushing capacity, maybe I may take another 10 minutes, not more than that. Crushing capacity of 5000, day of operation 180 days, total crushing 180 into 5000, it is a 90,000, 9 lakh metric ton. Okay, and then press mud produced from 9 lakh, it's around 36,000 metric ton, and then moisture content of press mud is 70%. Okay, so distillery capacity from 5000, you can go up to 100 kld distillery. Okay, and then from that 100 kld, 10% 1 liter equivalent, 1 liter of ethanol gives you 10 liter of press mud, sorry, spent wash. Okay, 1:10. Nowadays it has come down to 1:5 or 1:6, like that they are able to achieve because of the development and the recycle and other thing. Okay, but now however it is earlier case studies, worst case if you consider it's 1:10, then under 1000 m³. Solid is a 6% solid, in case if it is going for a biomethanation. So in a biomethanation, anaerobic digester will be used, and they are going to take the methane. Methane is used in the boiler. Okay, there's some volatile fatty acids and other things will be destructed in the anaerobic digester. Generally, the USB digesters are used, anaerobic flow blanket digester, okay, reactor. Biomethanation spent was after concentration in in ME, multi-effect evaporator. So this will come to 1,000, it is reduced to 200 metric ton actually. Okay, solids in biomethanate spent wash after evaporation is 30%. Maybe this 6% is increased to 30%. And then number of days operations is 270. This whenever there is because this operation may be less, but however it can go, distillery operation can go more actually. That is the reason they have taken 270 days actually. The total biomethane spent was available Available is 54,000 cubic meter by this into this if you multiply. Okay, so and then the press mud spent wash ratio is required 1:1.6 actually. Okay, that is a, see that is the reason even if it is generated more 54,000 meter cube and 36,000 meter cube, sorry, metric ton. Okay, so it is a 1 liter 1 kg required 1.6 liter spent wash. Okay, that is what the required requirement. So here mass balance of composting for 500 TCD sugar factory and 100 KLD is done. Press mud is already as we calculated here. We are going to get 33,750 metric ton press mud. Solid content is 30. And total solid in the available quantity this much. Spent wash is 54,000 solid content and then the total solid content. So total solid containing is 26,325 and annual compost production with 20% loss as CO2 with available we need to consider loss and other moisture content. Okay, so that is a 20% means this is a 0.8 and 35% means 0.65. Okay, this comes around totally, which is going to come from the total quantity from the after the oxidation of this volatile solids. It comes around 32,400 metric ton. Okay, in a year. So that is what we are going to get from this 32,400 metric ton. If you sell or if you to manage what is the cost required and per ton of cost per ton of process what is the cost is required we can estimate. Okay, so here I have just because this my PPT it is going down. I think now yeah. So the financial requirement. Okay, so there is a land 16 acre. There may be I consider 6 lakhs per acre because it is in a remote places. Compost yard concreting. Okay, that is some cost. Okay, like that we have taken all the cost which is required. Even plant and machineries is required. It is around 680 lakhs is the total. 680 lakhs is the total cost required to plan this compost facility. Okay, and then the cost of production of compost and profitability. Okay, so this is the cost. This is the total press mud what we are used actually. Okay, and then rate of press mud total cost which is going there, cost per metric ton we have calculated. Okay, and then compost operating cost. So there is a it is like a other moving parts and other machineries or salary wages and other operating costs which is a per metric ton is a 275 it is considered. Then this is the cost. Okay, interest on investment 10% on 680 lakhs because I need to consider the return of interest actually. Okay, that is the rate of interest and this is the cost which is there and per metric ton is like that. Okay, if you consider all this and then if you divide this by this 32,400 you will get 118 rupees per metric ton. Okay, so you can sell this per 1000 rupees. Saleable value of 32,000 metric compost at 1000 rupees. Nowadays they add some other nutrients, they will sell even 1400 1500, and even this MR this MCF and IFCO and other people, they'll go to them and they give the bag adding some nutrients and then they will say it's a organic compost like that. They sell also. Okay, in 2000 4000 bag they are going to sell. Okay, so per metric ton. So this what it's a cost actually. Okay, the total compost lined area and other facilities what is required is given, and this is how they are going to prepare the compost yard with a different there is a HDP film or liners will be done. Above that there's a concrete will be done and required as per the requirement. Okay, this is the concreted the compost yard which is there, and this is a biomethane spent wash storage lagoon actually. From there they will take it in the tanker and then do it. And then even whatever the leachate, they will allow it to collect here actually. Okay. So and then they need to have a garland drains all around so that this not contaminated. So such facilities also is required. Stormwater management has to be done for that drains and other required capacity. The flood management, all those things will be done. For that, there is a cost is going to be incurred. Okay. So this is the garland canal with retaining wall which is proposed in the compost yard actually. Okay, so that any rain which is there, which is collected and then go back to this lagoon, spent wash collection lagoon. Or nowadays this spent wash collection lagoon, they should not be more than 15 days storage capacity actually. They are reduced and they are asking for a cover storage. And then sometimes they also insist for a covered composting. But however, whatever they are suggesting may not be technically, economically feasible to cover 20 acre, 50 acre. And the process also will be reduced. The time decomposition time also is going to be reduced if so. Okay, this is a photograph showing sieving of compost and ready compost actually. So this is what the compost is ready to bagging or whatever. Okay, so limitation of composting, what is that limitation? See, we cannot tell only the advantages. There's some disadvantages also is there. Require huge quantity of solid organic residue, suitable for distilleries attached to sugar factory. Large land area is required for compost yard. Then compost operations are restricted to only dry season. Rain does not allow the compost operation, as you know, because of contamination and other problem. Operations are largely depend on casual labor or maybe temporary labors or whatever manpower. Okay. Benefit of compost. This is the limitations and this is the benefit. As you know already, you know most of the benefit which is taking place from the previous slides. Okay. The physical and chemical, ecological and economical benefit. What is going to be generating from this? You will be knowing, okay? The chemical benefit, which is because of you are going to avoid the fertilizer that is a inorganic fertilizer or chemical fertilizers, okay? And this organic chemical ecologically benefit the compost over 3 to 5 years actually. So see, this organic as compared to other fertilizer increase the production of all the crops 15 to 20%, reduce the use of chemical fertilizer 15 to 25%, and reduce the pesticide and herbicides, and then increase the strength and life of crop and okay, and overall cost of production increases actually. Okay, these are some of the benefits what it is dealt actually. This is the comparison of chemical fertilizer application with compost actually. As you know, there's a lot of you all know that what are the limitations in chemical fertilizer, what is the, because everybody is going for a organic and organic like that. Okay, so that is the reason you can feel that there are many advantages in this. Okay, direction for use actually, how you can use it actually. So use as a side dressing along with the row or for enriching plant at the time of sowing or prior to planting. Okay, so and uniform broadcasting in nurseries, lawns and landscaping. For potted plants, one part of bioorganic compost, 5 parts of soil, and use as a pot mixer. Okay, for because we cannot use it as a completely organic, so you require some other nutrient and inert material also. For fully grown plotted potted plants, apply 100 to 150 gram of bioorganic compost at least 7 to 10 centimeter below the soil surface, near root zone, and apply water. Repeat the application after every 6 months. Okay. For fruit trees, apply bioorganic compost around the plant near root zone by making 30 centimeter deep circular trench and mix thoroughly in soil and give water. That is what is required. Okay. These are given for various crops actually, how much to be added and what is the frequency to be added like that. Okay, so or when it is to be added. Scientists from Agriculture University observing the compost applied cane field. They have visited and they have seen the growth and other aspect in the cane. This is applied on a grape field actually, and this is what the grape grown by using this compost. This is a pomegranate is done. Okay, so this is what my friend, one of my friend actually from Renuka Sugar, Turumbekar is supposed to present. Since I am also involved with them in their all their what you called compliances and other things, and I keep visiting their plant. Then he said he is requested me to present since he is unable to speak because of some throat infection or something. He requested. That is the reason on behalf of him I should thank the Turumbekar for taking time and providing me information, and I hope I have shared also whatever the possible. You can see here in the pipeline, it is a steam pipeline. Anybody can tell what is the reason for they made it bend? Anyone in the participants?
Removal of condensate.
Expansion joint,
yes, sir. No, it's expansion removal of condensate. Joint. Condensate removal.
Yeah, expansion joint.
Yeah, trap. Okay.
It's anyway, a steam trap.
Steam trap. Anyhow, thank you for listening, and hope I have made this session informative and useful. And if you have any questions, maybe I can. Maybe there are some balancing and other thing. It requires a lot of time actually to explain with respect to various like a spent wash incineration for a molasses and for various other aspect I've been dealt. Anyway, but if time permits, we can discuss some other time. Okay.
Sir, there is a question from Manjunath SV. This is regarding what are the outdoor inhibiting components in the outdoor environment? Sorry, what are the odor inhibiting components in the outdoor environment? So what are those odor inhibiting components what you talked about?
Okay.
He wants to know.
No, there are some like curtains have been done with some perfumes actually. There are intermittent curtains with from some using some fragrance they are putting so that this odor is mixed with this fragrance. And then there's a divert this or mislead this odor. That is a one way they are doing in some cases. Okay.
It's other, similar to masking, am I right?
Masking, yes, masking. Other places they are making a huge plantation all round and which absorbs some, there are some specific species have been identified. Such species will absorb this odor and then it will become a screening and curtail this odor to neighboring area. But however, it is very difficult to working place. There is a odor generation. Surrounding can be done, and there are some odor in inhibiting what called that is called polymer, not polymer. They call it as silicon oil. There are odor inhibiting silicon oils are there actually. Nowadays, like a foam, this odor inhibiting silicon oils, they spray on the system. Or the silicon oil is not a, to some extent, it is not a hazardous or maybe toxic to microbes. Okay, it subsides to some extent, mask the odor in some cases. That's how they do. But otherwise, is invariably it generates odor actually. Like our farmyard composting, there also we generate. They generate. It is only generates when there is a therm. Thermophilic condition when reached. Not during mesophilic condition. When this higher temperature, that time it is, there will be some odor generation.
Yeah. Any other queries or questions you can ask to CTP Puttaswamy sir, or you can type in the chat box also.
Does this silicon oil, sir, there are some organic silicon oil have been invented actually or generated. Such will be used, which is a less adverse effect as compared to other synthetic silicon oil. I am not expert actually all this because I am only involved in legal, sorry, this compliance, environmental compliance aspect. I work with them, and so since I am involved with them almost since 15 years, visiting these industries, I little got up through by interaction. I learned through interaction.
So I think there's one more question. Does the okay when the compost will apply to agri farms?
Okay, yeah, that's what sir, generally that's what I told you, organic silicon based materials have been done oil. So Chetan, you can share the
The feedback link for session 2 is already shared. Okay. For the session 3 also I will be sharing.
You can share through both in chat as well as WhatsApp.
Sure.
So that they can complete it. Okay, there will be, I think, time lapse is there. You please do it at the earliest.
Sir, for both the session 2 and 3, presenter will be Puttaswamy sir itself, right?
You can
in the feedback.
You can put Thurumbekar name, madam, please.
For the session 3, you can add.
Add that as per the schedule only. You can
schedule.
Put. Yeah.
Okay. Fine, sir.
Session 2, you can put my name, and tomorrow any of my session is going to be taken by Thippaswamy sir.
Oh, okay, sir.
Yeah, I'll just share the feedback here also, as well as the thing. You can ask any other questions to CTPC.
And one more thing, some participant asked for waste innovative startup, actually some session. Actually, I'm trying, actually, if I'm getting any resource person to talk on that, we will try to organize. Otherwise, we can have a panel discussion with Ravi Shankar, with our Uttam, and then I can call. I have a person, a senior person, one Mr. Srivatsan, okay, and maybe I will find some other people who are working, even Karthikeyan, Chaitanyan, or somebody who, if they are interested, I think even other person like. I think Shekran is very good startup. He can give an idea. I'll try to request them to schedule the talk. I think on 5th day from 11:30 to 1, this Varun Upadhyaya, this program coordinator from Art of Living, is not confirmed actually. He was requesting me every alternative weeks actually, but now he has not replied. In case if it is not scheduled, this not happening, maybe I can arrange a panel discussion this hour. Hope that is okay with the participants, so that you can understand what is the startups can be done, and what all the avenues are there. In actually, I consider this, it is a waste, it is a well, whatever it is there is not a waste. It's all those things are in a wealth actually, even either industrial or municipal or whatever you can consider. Any questions, you can maybe 1 or 2 minutes we can conclude. Now I have completed well in time for both the sessions.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Tell me, sir.
Sir, in bio composting and everything, it is a zero pollution. You are telling it is all free from the bacteria and pathogens. Everything is killed. It is zero. It is possible, sir.
The Hello? Analysis, sir. The analysis report shows that it's a pathogen free.
Pathogen free? No, sir. Pathogens are, we cannot kill by the environment. Also, it will develop.
Actually, pathogen free, why it is because there is no such feedstocks are available or such possibility of entering that pathogens. That is the reason maybe it is a pathogen free, it is called. See, where the pathogen source actually excreta is the main reason for pathogens. Hope you understood.
Yeah, any other questions? Or some
topic is nice.
Yeah, I've shared that. Yeah, so I'll also share using the WhatsApp link, sir. I think we can close the session now.
Okay, if there is no nothing is there, we can close. Tomorrow we have a session by Mr. Basavayya. Actually, he is a retired managing director from Karnataka Compost Development Corporation, Government of Karnataka. He is also an advisor for many companies, okay, many government organizations. We'll have all of you request to assign login at before 9:30 so that we can start and complete it on time.
Yeah,
if nothing is there, we can close it.
Yeah, thank you, one and all. We'll close for today's session.